Hello, welcome to the Kuhn Experts Insights video series. I'm Ben Craker, Senior Product Manager here at Kuhn. Today I will be discussing a topic we often get asked about. Which type of conditioner is best in a mower conditioner? To answer this question, let's first review the goal of any conditioner. For hay producers, especially those putting up dry hay, time is everything. The longer the crop sits in the field, the greater the chance it is rained on or other field conditions can negatively impact the quality or in some cases quantity of the crop to be harvested. To help reduce the time the crop is in the field and potentially exposed to adverse weather conditions, conditioners are used to help the crop dry faster. This means trying to get the stems to dry out at the same rate as the nutritious leaves that tend to dry quite rapidly. Crop leaves contain the stomata where plants breathe, allowing moisture to rapidly escape after the crop has been cut. Stems, however, tend to have a tougher cuticle layer that restricts where moisture can leave the plant. The goal of any conditioner is to create openings in that waxy cuticle layer without damaging the leaves. Generally, there are two main types of conditioners: rollers that usually either have rubber or steel lugs, and a finger or flail conditioner. With these two overall categories, there are a wide variety of variations and terminology. For this video, however, we'll stay at a fairly high level and not get too far into all the different subtypes of conditioners. Either a roll or finger conditioner can do an effective job in a variety of crops, but there are some benefits and drawbacks of each type to consider. First, let's discuss finger conditioners. This type features fingers or flails that are attached to a central tube and can generally pivot. The other main component is called the conditioner panel. This panel controls how aggressively the crop is conditioned. The panel can be raised or lowered relative to the rotor to control how much the crop is forced into the fingers. This adjusts how much the crop rubs against the panel, the rest of the crop, and the fingers themselves. The goal being to rub openings in the waxy layer around the stem, allowing moisture to escape. Additionally, some machines, like most of the Kuhn lineup, have the ability to control the rotor speed to adjust for different field conditions or crops. An important consideration with this type of conditioner, especially with legume crops like alfalfa, is to ensure the machine is not set too aggressively, as this can bruise or strip the leaves off the crop, reducing nutritional value. An additional consideration for conditioners, particularly with disc type cutter bars, is the air turbulence created by the spinning of the conditioner. Finger conditioners can create a little less wind compared to roller conditioners. This can help in light crops or grassy crops without a fibrous stem, improving cutoff in some cases. Kuhn DigiDry conditioners feature a unique shaped steel finger that are laser cut. Using a laser ensures there are no rough edges that might cut the crop. Also, the boot shape helps reduce the air turbulence caused by the spinning of the conditioner. For roller conditioners, they again have the same goal of trying to create openings in the waxy layer of the stem of the crop. Depending on the type of roll and the tread pattern, this is achieved in slightly different ways. Generally, with steel or rubber rolls with deeper lugs, the conditioner works by putting a crimp in the crop every couple inches. The Kuhn double crimp steel rolls have an intermeshing square tread designed with 16 crimp points on each roller for maximum conditioning. These deeper lugs can also help feed through taller, stemmy crops by actively grabbing the crop and pulling it through the machine. The Kuhn diamond block rubber roll is the only roll designed for disc cutter bars on the market. Its tread pattern ensures the crop is crimped along its length, regardless of the direction it is fed through the conditioner. With disc cutter bars, it is more likely for crop to enter the conditioner parallel to the lugs, potentially reducing the number of crimps in the stem. Rubber or shallow lug conditioners work much the same way, but have more of a crushing action, cracking open the entire stem of the crop along its length. They run a smaller or in some cases zero gap between the rolls, relying on the pressure to crush the fibrous stem, opening large cracks for moisture to escape. Roller conditioners work a little like a gear pump when it comes to air turbulence. The two spinning rollers tend to create air that moves forward toward the cutter bar. So if the crop is light or does not have a tough stem to hold the crop up against the air, it can be blown over, reducing cut quality, especially with disc cutter bars. To reduce this effect, operators can lower the PTO speed to reduce the turbulence created by the rolls and increase ground speed at the same time to help mitigate the effect. This is often counterintuitive to most operators since many implements perform better when increasing PTO speed and reducing ground speed. Regardless of conditioner type, there are a few other key points that can affect drying time. First, it is important to leave tall enough stubble so the windrows are not lying directly on the ground. Crop touching the soil can often wick moisture up into the crop, extending drying time. Having the mower set to leave several inches of stubble can not only help drying, but can also reduce wear on the mower, streaking in the field, and overall ash incorporation in the windrow. Additionally, in most cases, spreading crop out into wide windrows or with a tedder can also improve dry down by exposing more crop to the sunlight. A conditioner can play a critical role in helping the crop dry quickly, maintain quality, and protect yield. It is important to have the mower conditioner set properly regardless of the conditioner type to achieve the best crop possible. Hopefully this video provided some insight into what type of machine best matches your needs when making hay. Thanks for watching. Look for more expert insights and other videos on my Kuhn or through our social media channels.